Hello friends and good afternoon. So I've been asked recently, what size tank should I have on my property if I have a family of six moving into my home? Let's get into it. So this is a good question and a question that pops up quite a bit, right? So generally, most people are concerned about the size of their tank so they can figure out how often should we pump out our tank? How important is it to pump out the tank? How full, fast are we gonna fill it up? And are we gonna cause some issues to the drain fields by having more people living in the home? These are good questions and they're very straightforward answers, right? So the best thing that we can think about real quick though is what is the daily flow per person when it comes to designing the tank, right? So previously we've covered how do they size the tank based off of bedroom count, but that only gives you a little bit of the picture, right? So if you're trying to figure out how big of a tank to use, usually, at least in our area, it's gonna be sized based off of the home. But not always are you gonna have the design spec worth of people living in that home. So let's talk about this. In our area, we generally will assume 75 gallons of water per person per day, right? So for two people, that would be about 150 gallons of water, just using basic math, right? So for six people, we're going to be looking at roughly 450 gallons of water per day. Now, that sounds like a lot of water, and it truly is. In practice, I would argue it's probably a little bit less water per day in use than that, right? I would say you're probably closer to 30 or 40 gallons of water per day, but it's always good to over-engineer the system so that way you can know for sure, yes, this system's gonna function and it's gonna function the way that it's intended and you're not gonna run into problems. All right, so 450 gallons of water, that's our minimum usage that we're gonna be having, right? So when we're sizing a septic tank, we wanna size for 2x, whatever that daily flow is. So in this particular circumstance, if we have a 450 gallon daily flow from six people, and we need to have two times that volume, that means our minimum size requirements can be 900 gallons. Now, in our state, generally, you're only gonna find 500 gallons, 750, 1,000, 1,250, 1,500, 2,000, right? Now, those are generally gonna be the increments. So if you've got a 900 gallon peak flow for 2 days worth of water for a family of six, you need to bump up to 1,000 gallons worth of capacity in order to adequately maintain that volume of water, right? And the reason why that's important, as you run water in the house, you shower, use the toilet, sink, etc., you're gonna run into the problem of the solids need time to fall out of suspension, right? So if you've got all that water flowing and you only got a 500 gallon tank and you're doing 450 per day, you're not really giving that water enough time to let the solids fall out of suspension. The best way I always recommend to picture this, get a cup of water and some baker's yeast, right? Mix it up real good and let it sit on the counter for a little while. You're gonna see that the heavy yeast falls to the bottom. You get this white foamy stuff at the top. Same concept as what's going on inside of a septic tank, right? So I'm gonna have a picture of a septic tank right here that is gonna show you what the different layers of separation are. So we're gonna have our scum, which is gonna be the top layer, the sludge, which is gonna be the bottom layer, and the effluent, which is the wastewater in the middle, right? So ideally, all of the heavy stuff falls to the bottom as your sludge. The lighter stuff's like your fats, toilet papers, hair, grease, etc., goes to the top. And then the baffle, which is gonna be that part in the back end of the tank, there's also one in the front, but the one in the back, its job's to keep the scum from floating into the pipes and causing problems in the drain fields. Now, let's just say, for example, that we go with that 500 gallon tank and we're not getting enough separation of the solids, right? What's gonna happen is, little bit of debris will work its way into the trench. And that little bit of debris over the course of 30, 40, 50 years is gonna plug up your drain fields and cause problems. Now, if you have an undersized tank and you're putting more people than the design spec, you are more likely to run into a premature failure, meaning you're probably gonna have a failure within 15 to 25 years versus getting all the way up to 50. Generally, a 50-year shelf life is gonna be something that where you're using less than the design spec. You might be asking, well, I don't know how big my tank is. Glad you asked. Super easy way to figure this out. So how you measure the tank is you just find all your corners, right? So usually how we do is we have a probe that we hit our edges and then we flag it, right? So if you go outside, you get a grounding rod or any other kind of metal pole, shove it in the ground till you hit the tank, flag where you hit the end of the tank, and then you just take a tape measure, it, right? Length times width times heights. So how you get the height though, is you gotta figure out the total volume of water in the tank. Usually there's a clean out or some other way to get into the tank to where you can measure that. So let's just say, for example, we know that it's an 8 foot by 4 foot by 4 foot tank, right? So we got 8 feet in length, 4 foot in width, 4 foot of water. Now we need to multiply by the gallons, right? So it's 7.5 times whatever that number is, that'll give you your gallon volume inside of that tank. A little bit of basic geometry for you. So generally when we do that math, you want to account for the wall thickness. You can do it more precisely, but if you just take off, you know, if let's just say you do that in math and it ends up giving you 1,100 gallons, well, more than likely it's not 1,100 gallons. It's probably closer to 1,000 gallons if you account for wall thickness, right? So that's the easy way to calculate it yourself. Now, in our area, remember how I said in the beginning that the bedroom count is what dictates the size of your tank. So that means that you, as a homeowner or purchaser, if you know that you're buying a home that has a 750-gallon tank and you know that your six-person family needs at least 900 or more, you need to be careful when it comes to buying any two-bedroom home or a three-bedroom home that is older than 1980 in our area. And the reason why is before 1980, a lot of the homes around us would have a 750-gallon tank on a three-bedroom home. And that's because back then it was only a 1.5 times multiplier. So if you're buying those older homes, you're gonna have an undersized tank, which can cause some problems with the absorption system and the separation of solids. So it's very important to make sure that you keep in mind how big that tank is. By getting a septic inspection or having the tank pumped, whoever that professional is should be able to get in there and let you know, like, hey, this is the size of the tank. This is how many gallons I pulled out. Now you know what you're working with. But remember, family of six, you want to be aiming for at least 1,000 gallons of water in that tank. So usually what that means is with a modern septic system, you're going to want to be darn near close to a three bedroom or a four bedroom home. Ideally with a family of six, you're hitting closer to the four bedroom because you're less likely to get the smaller tank, meaning that system should be able to accommodate your usage. Now, you might be saying, I don't understand that. Well, we covered this in a previous video, so go back and watch that video. But bedroom count times two, that's the design spec for how many people are supposed to be in that house. So if you have a three-bedroom home, it's designed for six. If you have a four-bedroom home, it's designed for eight, five, 10, so on and so forth. You just multiply by two, right? Usually that's not how that works out, but that's a good way to kind of do a little bit of quick math in your head, figure out what you're working with. Let me know below. When you bought your house, did you know how big your tank was? Did you do the math, or did you even think about the volume of water that you'd be putting it through, right? Let me know, I'm curious, right? So we're going back to maintenance, right? So if you have a family of six living in a house that only has a 750-gallon tank, now you need to be more conscious of that system, meaning you're gonna wanna make sure you pump out that tank more regularly. Generally, for a family of four, we usually recommend to pump out every 2 to 3 years. If you have a family of six and you have a smaller tank, you might want to consider bumping it down to every year, every other year, so that way you can avoid any of the solids building up in the system, right? The name of the game when it comes to a septic tank is keep the solids out of your drain fields. If you're not keeping the solids out of the drain fields, you're running the risk of causing premature failure or damage to those drain fields, which costs money, right? Because at that point, once those drain fields are saturated and they're done, it's game over. It's time to replace them. There's not really a whole lot you can do about that. It's also very important to make sure that if you're doing an addition on the home, that you keep in mind the sizing of your tank. So like in our counties, in Baltimore County and Maryland, Central Maryland, the county will get fussy and they will make you rip out that old tank and slap in a proper size tank if you build an addition. So for example, we have a garage right here, right? Let's just say that somebody wanted to put an additional dwelling unit in that garage. Well, right now there's nothing there. So what they would need to do is they would either need to find a way to connect the bathroom and the kitchen to the correct septic system over there, or they would have to put their own specific tank in for that property specifically, right? And the reason why is because the house is designed, or the septic system for the main house is designed for the bedroom count of that house and no more. So if you add a bedroom, right, to this, now you're over pushing the system and it's not gonna be able to keep up with the system's flow that you have going in. I get it. Even if you only have four people living in the house, if it's a four bedroom home, that means it's built for eight. If you add the fifth, well, now you got 10, even though you've not increased your occupancy status. I get it. It's silly, but that's the way the county does it, right? So you gotta be careful. So if you're gonna do any kind of additions, you need to make sure you're paying attention to the sizing of your tank way more in a minute focused fashion, right? I hope this was useful. I hope that this was insightful for you. If you gained some value from it, hit that like button, hit subscribe. Talk to me below. Let me know what you're going through at your house. Have you ever had to do this before? Tell me about your experiences. Did you ever have to increase the size of your tank? Did you ever think about the size of your tank? I'm curious. I hope this was a fun time. I look forward to talking to you guys in the comment section. Till next time, guys.